Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Temi, a software engineer working in London. I've been through the job search experience pretty recently, and I know how difficult it can be to figure out where you should look for a job, especially if you're looking for your first full-time role after university or college. So in this video, I'll be talking about some of the job boards I used whilst I was looking for jobs. Before I jump into the video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you're new here so that you can see more content from me. So my favorite job board is the LinkedIn job board. I know a lot of people don't like using LinkedIn for a number of reasons, but the job board is pretty good in my opinion. To get to the job board, you go to LinkedIn and then at the top here, you select the jobs icon. Then you get to this page and there are two search boxes. One for the title of the role, scale or company, and the other search bar for the city, state or zip code. I'll search for a software engineer in London. Then you get to this page and you'll see all of the roles here. The first feature I really like is that some job posts will show you how many people have already applied to the role. So I guess you might get an idea of how much competition you might have. You can see the number of employees at the company, and you also get to see if you have any connections who already work at the company, which is good because you can then decide to reach out to those connections if you want to find out more about the company or the role. You can also see if the role is full-time or part-time and how long ago it was posted. One of the main reasons I like this job board is because of the easy apply function. So you can click on the easy apply button, put in your email, phone number, and attach your CV, and then just click here to apply for the job. I also like how you can filter your job search here on the LinkedIn job board. So if I click on the All Filters button, there are loads of different filters you can apply, and I won't go through them all, but some good ones are the experience level filter. So you could put in entry or mid or executive or associate. You can also put in your job type. So you could say full-time, internship, temporary, or volunteer. Normally, when I search for roles, the filters I like to use are the experience level. I'll put that as junior or mid, depending on what kind of roles I'm looking at. I'll set the job type to full-time and the salary to more than 30K or more than 40K. The next job board I like to use is Glassdoor. You do need to sign up to Glassdoor to be able to use it. So once you've signed in, you get to this page and the job board operates in a similar way to the LinkedIn one. So you can search for a job title, keyword, or company. You can also automatically filter your search by company or salary or interviews as well if you want to do that. So to keep things the same, I'll just search for a software engineer again. I'll do software engineer London, England. That was a recent search. So this looks very similar to the LinkedIn one. And my favorite thing about this job board is that most companies will have a rating, as you can see here. This rating is based on the current and past employees who worked at these companies. And the rating is broken down into compensation and benefits, culture and values, career opportunities, and work-life balance. I think this is a really great feature because it gives you a rough idea of what the company culture and the working environment will be like. You can also see if the company is actively hiring. So it says here actively hiring, which is good because sometimes job ads on job boards are inactive. Someone might have posted it a month ago and filled that position, but they might not have notified Glassdoor or taken the time to take the job down. This actively hiring feature is also good because you know that you won't be wasting your time if you apply to the job, because if they're actively hiring, you'll be guaranteed to get some form of communication after you've applied for the role. So if I click on this job ad here for DeepMind, that is a nice salary, 55 to 78K. So what you can actually do is scroll down here and you will see a description of the job. So it tells you about the team and the role as well. If you scroll a bit further, they will also tell you things about the company. So it tells you how big it is, when it was founded, just snippets of information as well. And this is really cool. So you'll get the rating. So you can see how many people would recommend to a friend. 98% of people would. So this is clearly a good company to work for. And then you can see the rating here. And it says why work with us, and they have a little video here which you can click on, which is quite good. a bit different to LinkedIn's, a bit more comprehensive. As you can see, it's kind of similar to LinkedIn's, but there are some extra features which you don't have on there, which makes sense because Glassdoor is dedicated to applying for jobs and also reviewing jobs as well. A job board that some of you might not be aware of is the Stack Overflow job board. And this is great if you are a software engineer or a data scientist, because their job board is exclusive to software engineering and data science roles. So to get to it, you just go to stackoverflow.com, and in this little drop-down hamburger menu here, you click on it and you can go to jobs underneath find a job. And that should take you to the job board here. And at a first glance, it looks fairly similar to the others. The UI is a little bit different, not as attractive in my opinion. I'll go through some of the unique features of this job board. The first one is you can actually filter your roles by tech stack, which is kind of cool. So you can put in any tech that you do like and you'd like to work with. And alternatively, you can also put in any tech that you dislike. And I personally wouldn't do this, but you may have valid reasons for not wanting to work with certain tech. You can also come to this perks button here and specifically look for visa sponsors if you're looking to relocate to a different country, or if you're looking for roles that offer relocation as well. One thing I really like is this background filter. So you can come here to background and you can sort your experience level from minimum to maximum. So this filter starts all the way from student and goes all the way up to manager. I've never seen a job board start a student before, so it's nice that this job board is student friendly. I think a good thing about using this job board is that it's specific to developer jobs. So there will be some niche things that you can filter out, such as tech stack or engineering culture. If you're a Black woman based in the UK, a great job board to use is the Coding Black Females job board. If you're not aware of Coding Black Females, they are a nonprofit organization dedicated to getting more Black women into tech. This is a job board I use to get my current job, so I'm a big advocate for it. It's good because you know that the companies that post jobs on this job board will be dedicated to inclusivity and diversity, which is usually a really important factor for Black women when we're picking where to work. So what you do is you go to codingblackfemales.com and you can click on this hamburger icon here and go to jobs. And the jobs that appear here are the most recent ones, so the ones that are posted recently. And this one is grayed out, so I'm guessing they've closed the job and that's no longer open. And this is pretty easy to navigate. You can search for jobs by using keywords or by location as well. There are some unique job filters here which I haven't seen anywhere else, so I'll quickly go through them. So you can filter out roles for apprenticeships, bootcamp, graduates, if you want a freelance role, full-time, graduate program or graduate scheme, internships. So it's clear that this is very friendly towards people who are looking to break into tech. So you can easily take this off here and see what companies will be willing to hire graduates or people looking for bootcamp or apprenticeships as well. So there's quite a few here, which is great. These were just some of the job boards I used when I was searching for jobs. If there are any job boards that you like to use, then do let me know by leaving them in the comment section down below. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you next time. Bye.